Joining me now, CNN law enforcement analyst Jonathan Wackrow, a former Secret Service agent during the Obama administration, and retired Air Force Lieutenant Colonel Rick Francona, a former U.S. military attaché in Syria. Jonathan, let's talk first about this great story that's on CNN.com, written by our friend Noah Gray. If you haven't read it yet, I highly recommend it on CNN.com. Talks about this picture that was posted online before we knew definitively that the president was in Iraq. This was a plane spotter in England who thought he saw what looked like Air Force One making its way through the skies, took a picture of it and posted it. Then we found out that was indeed it. I mean, how do you keep something like this secret? And when you were working on President Obama's detail, it must be difficult.
Well, thankfully, we didn't have, you know, the social media that we have today. The followers that are constantly monitoring social media, the digital platforms to, you know, see where the president's moving at all times, the first lady. I mean, that's a new vulnerability that the Secret Service, the military, you know, has to face now every single day. I mean, there was no mistaking what that aircraft was when that was posted online. I actually saw it, you know, right after it was posted, and I said, This is a game changer for the Secret Service. But again, now that they understand that a vulnerability like this can, you know, telegraph the movements of confidential and private travel by the president, you know, they'll just change. They'll change their tactics. Right. Again, in this case, it really didn't amount to canceling the visit or, you know, jeopardize the mission at the end of the day. However, going forward, it's going to change the way that they operate.
I mean, does he have to travel in that specific plane? I know there are two versions of that plane that are clearly what we call Air Force One when the president is on board. I mean, couldn't they come up with some other mode of transportation that isn't so obvious when it's in the sky?
Well, I think for the next combat zone trip, they absolutely will. You know, but for right now, that aircraft, Air Force One, has all the communications. It has all the necessary equipment to maintain the continuity of operations for the United States. It has all the, you know, medical gear. It has every contingency plan on board that specific aircraft pursuant to the protection and safety of the president and first lady. So right now, that's the asset. I'm on a go-forward basis. I'm sure that may change.
We may see that change. Well, Colonel, let's go to you now. Now, the president said that this trip was planned 3 or 4 weeks ago. Now, we know for general security reasons that presidential trips to war zones are kept quiet, but explain the specific concerns there are when a president goes into a combat area.
Well, of course, you've got other people that don't wish us well. Nothing would suit them better than to put the president at risk. So, you know, anywhere the president goes, they've got to do all the advance work. They've got to maintain security, and they've got to make sure he's safe while he's on the ground. This is a big operation. It's very hard to do without being discovered, as you've been talking about. It's very hard to move aircraft around. And it's not just one aircraft. I've handled presidential visits in the past, and it's usually about 10 aircraft over a period of time. They have to bring all the equipment, all the communications. So it's not just an airplane landing somewhere. A big, big operation. Lots of logistics, lots of moving parts.
And speaking of those logistics, there was a meeting that was scheduled with the Prime Minister of Iraq. That meeting was canceled. Sarah Sanders, the press secretary, said it was for security reasons that the White House was only able to invite the Prime Minister 2 hours before the scheduled meeting time. I mean, does that sound correct? Should they have given the Iraqis more notice? Or is there a real vulnerability there that if you inform someone in Iraq's government that could then leak out to someone who would have perhaps nefarious intentions?
I would say that it was for security reasons. You would not tell everybody. Well, you wouldn't tell the Iraqi government that the Iraqi government is riddled with Iranian agents. And in fact, the Iraqi government may have officially notified the Iranians. So that's something that I understand why they would keep it close hold. I know the Iraqis were very upset. They said this was an impingement on their sovereignty and all that. But when you're making these arrangements, the safety of the U.S. president is paramount from our side.
Right. I do think we sometimes take this for granted, right? How difficult it is to move someone who is as important as a president of the United States into such a dangerous place. The Secret Service, the military do a terrific job of keeping the president safe. Colonel Francona, Jonathan Wackrow, thank you very much for your